Hey guys,
bet you didn't see this coming. We're going to rank Beabadoobee's albums, which is going to include her EPs, because if we didn't, we'd only be covering two albums, Fake It Flowers and Beatopia, and that's not very fun. Let's start with the first EP, Lice, which came out in early 2018. First track is Home Alone. Opens up with a sweet, somber guitar cut with some even nice lyrics about staying up late at night and not being able to sleep because of this man or whatever. I can't relate to that. The song is short, but it's actually relatively long compared to the other songs, except the next song, Bobby. This song is lyrically describing this character of Bobby, who is this depressed 14-year-old girl who wants to accept the love that's given to her. Bobby desperately wants to be happy, but she can't. The song is 3.5 minutes long and has 3 verses, and I think it's cool. Was I super compelled by the writing on this one? No, not really. These influences like Pavement and Silver Jews do this sort of slow melodic storytelling much better, but B is like 18 years old when she made this, so I'm not expecting anything super groundbreaking 10 out of 10 lyrics, like, ever. But I still like the song, so whatever, moving on. Spacing Out is a simple and poetic song. It's the first song I liked off the album on first listen. Just the simple image of floating off into space and needing someone to hold you kept me hooked. It also helped that the floaty production makes you feel like what the lyrics are describing. Really solid cut, check it out. And the closer is Angry Song. The song is good, short, sweet, angsty, I wish it had drums. The lyrics are like diary pages, take that however you want. Personally, I think it's fine. I've definitely written a song like this just to like let it out, but man, I wish it had drums on it. I'm hoping one of the goblins in the comment sections will figure out like a live recording of B playing this with a full band, thank you. Overall, the song is like a 6 out of 10, but overall, the album is like hovering between like a 4.5 and a 5, and that's not like because it's bad, but because it's so goddamn short. My main complaint is the lack of sonic diversity. This is kind of a problem that I'm gonna face when I'm covering B's music from this early 2018 period, because it's pretty much just like B and her guitar, but whatever, let's move on. Patched Up is the next project released in 2018. Everest starts off the track list. And it's a song about the fear of what's to come in the near future and all the things holding you back, but still encouraging you to keep going while admitting that the narrator, B in this case, is scared as well. The production of the song is a little cleaner than on Lice, but still feels like a little compressed. The same guitar and vocal production takes over like it did on the last album, but honestly, I'm just waiting for like the first snare drum to hit in this, you know, there's a snare. And guess what? When we got to the next track, finally a snare drum came into the mix. The song is 10 out of 10. Thank you. It also has Glockenspiel. Its lyrics talk about the moment in time we all go through where everything seems pointless and you feel like you're drowning in an endless pit. And I think it captures that feeling really well. Did I mention it has a snare drum in it? Next song is Dance With Me. I kind of have mixed feelings about this song. It really starts to drag after the lyrics run out. I feel like the song's climax could have been so much greater, but it sort of just fizzles out after the midpoint. Art Class is another slow acoustic guitar cut about a narrator who just wants to be noticed by this guy in her art class, but she's like afraid of rejection. She wants to make the first move, but she can't because she fucking feels like she's gonna get rejected. It's a cute song, if a little long. It's kind of a crazy jump from some of these like 1 minute songs to 4 minute songs. Overall, this song didn't really stick with me besides the first verse. I like the line, "Good, you've been looking at me twice as more." If You Want To is the next song, and this is a hit, no question. It's got all of the instruments, the guitar is bent to shit, the chorus is sticky to the brain, no question, we're moving on. 18 is my favorite ballad on the album. I think the laid-back way the whole song is presented really works to its advantage. The lyrics are sharp and don't over-explain. I really like the refrain, and June the 3rd is coming closer and I'm nowhere near closure. The last song is The Way I Spoke. Let me ask one thing. Why are the last 30 seconds of this just filler? I think it's just to like run out the print distribution time, but it just sounds kind of awkward to have this like really long song and then it's like just 30 seconds of silence. Besides that, I have no major complaints. It's another solid song, but not my favorite. And overall, the ranking of this album is 5.5 out of 10. Better songs, real drums, good improvement over the first EP. Let's move on. 1 year later, Love Worm. Disappear is the intro to this album, and it's a damn way to start an album off with a real fucking bummer. The song is about thinking back on a once loving relationship that has since lost its romance. I love the progression of the lyrics from why it disappeared to yeah, that shit's disappeared to why'd you disappear. Progressively, the whole person is gone over the whole song. Great song, real shoegazy, but the lyrics are in the front, so it's more like a staring in the crowd gazing. Oh my god, I can't believe I wrote. 1999 is the next song, and it's in a 3-4 shuffle, which sways between frigid guitars and B's sugary melancholy. It's an emotional cut detailing the unhealed tension with a past lover, and it's really quite a good song. I see why people like it. Apple Cider was the single, and for good reason, it picks up the pace and delivers one of the most infectious first lines in B's discography. I'm sure if I listened to this song like 100 times, it's probably not as good as it used to be, but it's an incredibly hooky song. The next song is Ceilings, a pretty underrated song on the album. It's a bit all over the place. In a way, I kind of like it. It goes from one synth to another to B crooning over the song with her traditional whispery voice. I wouldn't put it on a playlist, but it's pretty good to zone out to. The next song is Angel. It's my favorite song on the record. I love the pensive drumming on it, always anticipating, and the refrain of your bones are only painted gold gets stuck in my brain. You Lie All the Time is probably the best song on the record. Not my favorite, but probably the best song on the record. I get a huge Strokes feeling from this song, and also feel like a Yeah Yeah Yeahs feeling from it. It's magical, truly nostalgia in sonic form. And B's vocals on this song are impeccable. I love the way that she sings the lines, that every time we do, we look the other way. She kinda has this inflection similar to, wait for it, Bareface from Brockhampton. I can't wait to see the one Brockhampton fan in the comments tell me I'm a fucking lunatic. But also, this song is like the fastest 4-minute song ever. Alright, last song is Soarin', and it's about B's boyfriend, and there's not really much to it, and this song is in a 3-4 shuffle, same as 1999. But at least 1999, like, had drums. This song only has guitar and piano, and it kind of drags in my opinion. I know it's a love song, and it's kind of hard to hear considering the circumstances of their relationship on later albums. Overall, the album is 7 out of 10. I liked 5 out of the 7 songs, with my favorite being You Lie All the Time, and my least favorite being Ceilings. Alright, next EP, Space Cadet 2019. And from what I know, this is some people's favorite EP slash era of Beabadoobee. First song is Are You Sure? And unlike some of her early work, is underpinned with a certain kind of darkness that I don't really see in her other songs, with a pretty dissonant guitar passage from about the 1 minute mark to the verse. I think the song is pretty unique in B's discography and shows some real cool experimentation while still being pretty firmly in the 90s pop rock realm. I Wish I Was Stephen Malcolmist was the second single, and it's pretty good. I mean, really good. I like the way that you can hear B fuck up the vocals during the song. It makes the song feel like a more holistic experience, though I don't really like the guitar solo in the song. I'm kind of spoiled because I've been listening to so much Dinosaur Jr. Sun More Often is next, and if I'm being honest with you, I didn't have high hopes for this song, but it actually turned out to be one of my favorites. I feel like the band really get to play around, not to mention B's voice on this is perfect. I couldn't ask for more. I want more of this. All right, next song is the first single, She Plays Bass. This was the first Beabadoobee song I ever heard, and it's pretty solid. It's their most popular song on this EP, and I think it mostly is equal parts because it's a good song, and also because it has a really good music video. That was the way I discovered it, was through the music video on YouTube. Last song is Space Cadet, and what a journey this song is. It really reminds me of something that the 1975 were doing around this time with the staccato synths and disorienting bass. I don't really know how else to say, but this is good song. Now you might look at this analysis and go, Eden, did you just say that you liked every single song? And yes, I did. And would I give this a 10 out of 10? Not necessarily. It's pretty good, but I give it a 9.5 out of 10. Let's talk about Fake It Flowers. Care is the first song, and it's about B confronting people who have caused her harm or have failed to listen to her, and she needs a shoulder to cry on. It demonstrates B's weakness, but it also demonstrates her courage and independence from the situation. Now, while I do admire the song's message, I think the instrumental is a little bit generic with its constant stopping and starting straight out of like the early 2000s. It's not like terrible, but like it's kind of played out. The next song is Worth It, which is coincidentally the exact same length as the previous song, Care. Just thought I should mention it. And the song is pretty good. Really solid chorus and pretty synth backing on this song. Diet Red is also pretty good. Good mellow song that washes over you like a clean mist. I thought the first handful of lyrics weren't great, but once the song started to get going, I really enjoyed it. Not one of her most like creative choruses, but kind of treading over old ground with all the hair colors and whatnot. Anyways, whatever. Stephen Malcolmist. Back to Mars is an interlude, so I'm gonna talk about it, you know, not that long. But I wish the lyrics kept going on, because I started to get into it, and then I realized the song's only like a minute and a half. Next song is Charlie Brown. It's cool, but I feel like the verses could have used something to spice them up. The chorus is pretty explosive, though, and B layering four voices on top of each other with some overdrive effects, it's probably like the most blown out performance. It's pretty cool. Will I come back to this song, though? Probably not. Emo song, which is kind of a weird one. There's a lot going on here with the synthetic bass and the electronic hi-hats sputtering like a car engine. It's kind of not working for me, not to mention the glockenspiel or like the bell sound. It sounds really unmixed for some reason. Next track is Sorry, and it better be as good as the Alex G version. And my conclusion is, it's not. Honestly, it's kind of like a really high bar to set any song to, but it's still pretty good. I really like the strings on the song, and giving the track an extra bit of drama that I haven't felt from the previous cuts. And I like that the drums wait 2.5 minutes before absolutely swallowing the mix. Further Away is a good 6-4 ballad that B described as kind of talking about the people who were always mean to me in school, people mean to me in general, kind of me accepting the fact that they're never gonna understand me. A good statement piece for the record. It's a bit slower than the other ones, but I quite like it. The last couple of tracks I wanted to talk about are Together and Yoshimi Forest Magdalene. Together being a really good example of B's songwriting and cool rhythmic patterns with some more traditional verse-chorus structure, and Yoshimi Forest Magdalene being the closest thing to a shoegaze slash dream pop song yet. I like both songs. That rounds out this part of the video. Fake It Flowers is not as good as Space Cadet, but it's still pretty good. I liked 7 out of the 12 tracks. And if B put another EP with Care, Worth It, Diet Red, Sorry, Further Away, and the last two I talked about, it would be probably a 9 out of 10 as well, but unfortunately there are a lot of songs on this album that I just didn't really like get, or maybe just weren't as impactful as songs on Space Cadet. Next is Our Extended Play. Oh sorry, I forgot to rank. 7.5 out of 10, because I feel like there's a lot of ideas that aren't fully realized. Next is Our Extended Play, which came out 2 years after Fake It Flowers. First off, you know how I was just saying that Yoshimi Forest Magdalene was B at their most shoegazy? Well, think again, because the song Last Day on Earth exists. This is probably B at their most shoegazy dream pop ever. And this is also probably my favorite song that B has ever made, point blank period. With the biblical references through the verses, you got a problem with Peter, you got a problem with Paul, and the first part about burning churches. It's an absolutely melodically sludgy mess with these guitars and bass. I love this song. It's horrifically apocalyptic, but still uplifting in an interesting way. It's definitely interesting for sure. Okay, next track, Cologne. I'm actually not gonna talk about this song. Animal Noises is sick. The lyrics on this song are just really fucking good. I don't know what else to say. The song has a banjo and it still sounds good, which makes me wonder who the fuck produced this song. And I looked it up and it's Matty Healy and George Daniel from the 1975. I was just fucking talking about them. I know I'm not alone when I say that my favorite lyrics on this song are maybe the things that made you want to live were the things that made me want to die. This song is my second favorite. He gets me so high, ridiculously hooky, pure sugar in the blood. How else can I say that this song is good? This EP gets an 8.5 out of 10 to me. It's another step forward for the band, and I think the songs are really good, even if I don't like listening to Cologne, ever. Next album came out a year after this, and it's probably their most highly anticipated, and that is Beatopia. We open with the intro Beatopia cult song, and I hate to ruin anyone's perception, but once the song breaks into the part with the vocals and the guitar, it kind of sounds like Loser by Beck, and I never made that connection until while I was writing this script. Just try to sing the melody of him and put it over the... It's... I don't know. Anyway, song perfectly transitions into 1036, which is a banger, no doubt. It's a bedroom pop and indie rock anthem with an immensely catchy production. It super carries for sure. B's lyrics capture these distinct and devastating sentiments about relationships from both her perspective and experience, and add an extra layer of sentimentality to them. Not much else to say, but check that shit out. Sunny Day has this heavy Nelly Furtado influence on it, like laid-back R&B flow through the whole song. It's not the most out-there thing B has ever made, but it's a good summer song, and I really just think it's a good song in general. See You Soon is fine, if a bit repetitive. With three short verses, there's not much contained in them. I don't really come back to this song. Ripples has some nice Baroque orchestral flourishes, and it might be the most acoustic slash classical of any of the songs, but there's not much to say about it other than that. The next song is, I'll just play the first chord, you know what I'm talking about. Broken CD is rather interesting, it's an interlude, but I like the brief vignette that B lets us see in this song. When the drums and piano come in, it gives the tightest hint of like the garden or Macabre Plaza. Next song, Talk, banger. Let's move on. Love song. This is the song about the train. Picture of Us. This song is like an American football song disguised as a Beabadoobee song. I swear to God, I don't fucking believe it. B floats like a fairy over this math rock style finger-picked guitar over this super beautiful song. I totally didn't expect this after all the other songs. Fucking awesome for sure, and I'm putting it on my playlist. Next song is Fairy Song. I want to highlight the production on this song as just so uniquely compressed, and not in a bad way. It uses the pulsating frequencies to pull out bits and pieces of the mix to great effect in the chorus section. The lyrics can be a bit, insert title card here, it says depressing. Don't get the deal. Maybe it's just me, but this is the first time that I'm noticing Jacob Bugden. I think I'm saying his name right. His voice is on this song. Don't get me wrong, he has a good voice. I didn't hear him before. Tinkerbell is overrated. Do I like this song? No, not really. Not the strongest chorus, and the feature from Pink Panthers actually, I don't know, I just didn't really vibe with it. I won't revisit this on a second listen, but it's cool if you want to listen to something more electronically based. And lastly, You're Here, That's the Thing, is a nice way to close out the album. And I'm gonna give this album 8 out of 10. Because honestly, most of it was pretty fucking good. Some of my favorite songs are on this album, and I didn't really talk in depth about some of the hit singles because, like, if you haven't heard them and you're watching this video, what are you doing? I'm kind of here to try to give you all the cool underground. I'm trying to give you the cool B-sides off these records because it's pretty sick. All right, I'm really quickly going to talk about all of the stuff that has come out post Beatopia. Cyber Kiss to You, which was on Black Star Kids album. Really super fucking awesome banger song. Listen to that right now. Super underrated. Put that on all your playlists. Next song came out this year. It's Glue Song. And also there's a companion, which has Claro on it. Both songs are, you know, fine. I think they're good. I like Glue Song. And most recently, The Way Things Go came out, I think, like, fucking, like, a month ago or something, 2 weeks ago, something like that. I'm really looking forward to what Beabadoobee will release next, with talks of, like, a with talks of a Beabadoobee 3 coming out sometime in a theater near you. Hopefully, we won't have to wait too long. All right, thanks for watching my video. Bye. I should talk. Okay, thanks for watching my video. Also, I wanted to save this for the end. I hit 1,000 subscribers yesterday, so I wanted to say thank you. The last fucking subscriber milestone I made was for 500, and now we've doubled in size, which is really super duper awesome, super duper fucking sick. Thank you to all my 1,000 subscribers. Bye.